Dover Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. It was a pretty good weekend of boxing, but you have to, the very first thing you have to say is rest in peace to Marvelous, Marvin Hagler, right? Even if you're young, you do understand, you've heard the name a lot. But people who have seen him fight, understood the magnitude of his fights, of his, accolades, what he was able to accomplish. He had lost a whole bunch of years in a row, like 38 fights in a row. He's probably, when you talk about best middleweights ever, his name is going to show up. Just awesome fighter. And he's passed away at a very young age. 66 is a baby, right? He's passed away. So, rest in peace. So many things right now, with all the stuff that's going on, just you're constantly hearing people passing away, and it's just very sad. So that is the major story, right? And actually, Marvin Hagler deserves a lot of videos. I'm sure a lot of people will be doing those, so to make the young generation understand what he is, what he was, and who he was able to beat and conquer, and the things he was able to do. And I can remember, a lot of fights, like, for example, when he fought Sugar Ray Leonard, I wasn't even going for Marvin Hagler, right? But, lots of times when you don't go for somebody because you know they're the favorites, you know what I mean? In a lot of sports. So, just a very, very awesome fighter, Marvin Hagler. Really, rest in peace. Let's get to the night and the day of boxing, no matter where you are in the world. There was a lot of fights. 115-pounder Rumazai, who's known for his two wins against Roman Gonzalez, Chocolito. He took handle his business. I forget the name he was fighting. It was a guy coming up in weight, an older guy, about 38, 39. He was the favorite. He handled that very convincingly, I think, third-round stoppage. So, you don't have to say that. The significance of that fight is because Soar Rungvisai is going to fight the winner of Chocolito, Roman Gonzalez, and Estrada. So, and which we'll get to. So, he handled his business pretty convincingly. Now, you had an undisputed fight in the welterweight division in the women's game, right? And you had your girl McCaskill, right? She was fighting Cecilia Brikus, right? I think it's Jessica McCaskill. Against Cecilia Brikus, and Brikus was the undisputed champ for a long time. She had won 36 fights in a row, hadn't lost in the quote conversation, and then she lost to McCaskill because McCaskill was a aggressor in that one fight. And so I watched this fight intently, and kept my focus on it. And I think we had not a robbery here, but I think the wrong person won. But I'm by myself on that. Everybody, because McCaskill is a favorite. Not the favorite, but she's the champ now, and she was coming forward, and trying to throw the harder punches. But I thought the counter punching and the boxing ability of Brikus, there's a lot of punches that people don't see. It seemed to me like people who are judging the fight are judging it like they're judging a bar fight. She's coming forward, throwing hard right hands, and landed a couple. It's no doubt about it. I think the harder punches of the fight, if you have the two hardest punches of the fight, probably would have been for McCaskill. But I saw a lot of counter punching, a lot of counter left hooks when she would miss the right hand. So, maybe I'm out there. I had Brikus winning by a two-round margin, as a matter of fact. When she lost, somebody didn't even really give her a round or so. So they were saying, well, it's Texas, and they love the aggression in Texas. And I'm just like, yeah, but probably not really, depending on who. So I'm out there. McCaskill won, and she's still undisputed, and they're looking for her to fight Katie Taylor in a very, very lucrative fight, which you can only, in the women's game, you can only give props to them and hope that that happens, right? But I just do, Cecilia Brikus seems like a very, very class act, and I thought she did enough. She's a boxer, but she had to stand there after getting hit a couple of times. She's done her stuff. I think the referee, I wrote in round four, as a little note, I said this referee in round four, he reminded me of, rest in peace again, but Eddie Cotton, a good referee from the day, the big guy. He would do the bigger guys in the fights because he was about 6'6 himself. And I remember watching Mike Tyson versus Lennox Lewis, and he was getting on my damn nerves. The whole fight. It was like, well, why are you picking on Lewis in here? This stuff that you're talking about, really, man, you're picking. And it was similar with this referee with Brykus. It's like this girl, you know, McCaskill's coming forward, missing right hand, and she's shorter, so she lands, she ends up under, down under, and the other, you automatically fall on her a little bit because she missed, and so you're keeping her then down at that point until the referee says break. And she kept getting warned for holding to the point where she got a point taken. And I don't think I've seen a lot more holding than that. Vladimir Klitschko wouldn't have had a career if that was too much holding. So it's just a little bit, when you watch a lot of fighting, that wasn't right. So I had Brykus winning the fight, so I think that was a wrong decision in my opinion. But hey, McCaskill won, and more power to her. I just think Cecilia Brykus, keep your head up and you're a class act. Now, another fight was David Benavidez, undefeated, super welterweight, the guy who Canelo supposed to be fighting. Canelo got that belt given to him, right? And the WBC belt. He was the WBC champion, but he missed weight in the fight. And so now, you know, they gave the belt to Canelo without letting him fight for it. And when you watch his fight against Ronald Ellis, a lot of things are going to stand out. You know, his punching power, the speed of his punches, the fact that he was still able, the combination punches is exemplary, it's ridiculous. He looked great. And his opponent, Ronald Ellis, will get a lot of gigs after you go to the hospital first. They're going to have to check him because he was took punishment for 11 rounds and was game. It was so awesome how game this guy was. It was ridiculous. They had to stop it because he was ready to continue because he was not only taking a lot of punches, coming back, right, but he was coherent in the corner. He was holding conversations. It looked like he could do some stand-up comedy in between rounds. I mean, it was incredible to see what he was able to take, but you know, so that's one take from it. So Ronald Ellis will be getting fights because people are going to say this is the epitome of durable. But your boy Benavidez, it's the reason why Canelo ain't trying to fight him. You see that in the fight. You can see. I have Benavidez beating Billy Joe Saunders, right? Because Billy Joe Saunders, Benavidez is able to walk you down like he was Ellis, right? And I think Ellis has the same punch and power of a Caleb Plant or a Billy Joe Saunders. If he's able to walk you down, he's going to be taller than both of those fighters. And even though they're fast fighters, Caleb Plant and Billy Joe Saunders, they're not so much faster than David Benavidez, if at all. And he's going to have a reach advantage, and his punches are coming with power. I think at the end of the day, he's going to catch those guys. Or normally when those guys would outpoint somebody, I don't see him outpointing David Benavidez. Now, when you're talking Canelo, even though I don't roll with Canelo, I think Canelo was one of the biggest problems in boxing. I think the boxing is all in cahoots in hiding him and letting him navigate the system, right? And it's absolutely ridiculous, so I talk about it a lot. But that does not mean that I don't see what Canelo has to offer. Canelo is a different story. Canelo might get out-jabbed here, right? But we saw Canelo out-jab Caleb Smith. It was a Caleb Smith with a 4-week training camp and that wasn't trying to win the fight. This guy here is going to be different. I just think that he's going to have to at least worry about what's coming back from Canelo, which would change how the fight looks. And he's going to have to worry about that body, right? You just walking Ellis down because ain't nothing really coming back that's what you're worried about. It would have to be different. You're going to have that head movement because Canelo going to hit that body a lot first, and then he's going to come up with left hook to the head. So that's going to be a different fight. But I understand why Canelo is apprehensive about fighting this guy, right? If I would have to say the best 168-pounder, I'm going with David Benavidez, right? And Canelo right there with each other, right? That's the fight that has to happen there. That's the fight that's, you know, I think is the best fight there, and he just proved it again. So he wins with an 11th round stoppage because the referee just said, come on, man, I'm going to stop this fight, right? So let's go to the biggest fight. You know, Roman Chocolito, you know, Gonzalez against Juan Estrada, right? And Estrada's the man. Matter of fact, Estrada's the champ now. Roman Gonzalez, people know him as Chocolatito, right? No, whatever. He was number one pound for pound before, which we had issues with, and I still do. I think that him or Estrada in the top 5 pound for pound is a stretch because I think they both get hit too much. I think once you get to that top 5 pound for pound, there has to be a little elusiveness there, you know, where it's like I'm hitting you way more than you're hitting me. It's hard to hit me. You know, that those are top five. But, and you know, this guy, this was a barn burner of a fight from round one. whole lot of punches thrown. They threw over 2,000 punches. They was coming at him. But I'm not going to get into the fight much. It was just very exciting. Go and watch it. It was an exciting fight. But at the end, the wrong person won. Estrada won that fight. He got the fight given to him. And I don't think he won the fight. I had Roman Gonzalez winning that fight. Chocolito won that fight. To me, I think he landed more and more significant punches in the fight. Estrada was there. You know, I didn't think it should have been a split decision. I think it should have been a unanimous decision, like a close one. Like, you know, well, maybe one would say 116-112 and the other two would say 115-113. It should have been something like that for Roman Gonzalez. I didn't see Estrada winning that fight, but there you go. You know, I'm cross-eyed, man. That's why I got these glasses on, man, because I'm cross-eyed. I can't see nothing, obviously, right? So, you know, that's how it was with the weekend of boxing. It was a lot of things going on. I took my time and watched pretty much every fight this time. Normally, I don't because some hoops on or something else. But at the end of the day, I was like, you know what? I'm going to watch all these fights, but I'm going to talk about them in one video. I'm not going to be trying to make all these damn videos. You know, I'm not monetized, guys. So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, everything in one video, figure out a title to give to you guys. And you guys go check it out, see if I'm right about it. At the end of the day, Sor Rungvisai handled his business. Cecilia Brikus, I think, not got robbed, but I think she actually beat McCaskill, but she didn't. McCaskill gets that win. Estrada gets a win over Gonzalez, which I didn't think he did, right? And your boy David Benavidez showed why, you know, ain't nobody in a rush to fight this guy. That's what happened in this weekend of boxing. So I hope you enjoyed it. If not, go back and watch a couple of these fights and check them out. And let me know what you think about them. You know, am I out there? You know what I'm saying? Am I out there? Am I really cross-eyed? What's going on? Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.